Hey, how are you? My name is Emilio and thank you so much for joining me on this video today. I'm super excited to be showing you how to recover data from your Mac. Now, I've got myself a MacBook Pro. I've got a number of other Macs that I use for my demos, for my lab. And isn't it annoying when your data is deleted and then you can't get it back? You don't have a backup. If your hard drive fails, you lose data, wherever it may be, so often you're tempted to now go and take it to a data recovery specialist and they charge you a lot of money to get that data back. I always recommend you try to do it yourself first. Now, I know you have, I have countless times accidentally deleted data or even purposefully deleted data and then realized later on I actually need to get it back and it's gone. I don't have a backup of it. And you may think all hope is lost, but there is hope for you to be able to recover files. But let's log into my Mac right now and we'll show you how to do it and how to recover files. All right, so we've logged into our Mac. Now I've gone into Google and I've searched for this application called Stellar Data Recovery. So you can just literally go into Google and type in Stellar. And this is the software that we're gonna be using for recovering some data. Now it is free. You do have some limitations with the free version, but it is great and you can still do a lot with the free version. But if you want to be able to recover more and more data, for example, then you need to go and get some further versions available. But what we're going to do is under here, you've got a separate version here for Mac for individuals, and we're going to do a Mac data recovery. Here are three options: free, professional, and premium. We're going to go and use the free one right here, and it's a free download. So let's just go ahead and download it, install it. All right, so it's downloaded it here to my desktop. It's a zip file. We're just gonna double click on it and it'll open it up. All right, and here is the app. So we can drag that now into our applications folder. So just grab it and drag it into apps. So here is the app right here that we've just downloaded. Now it's just gonna give you a little bit of a warning because you downloaded it from the internet, but we're okay with that. You input in the administrator password. All right, so that has now opened up. Here is where we actually now select some information. Now there's a couple things that I wanna deal with first. Now, if we go into system preferences, this is just one thing you need to be aware of. Under here, you've got an area called security and privacy. Now, if for whatever reason you weren't able to open up the app because it's only allows you to do downloads from an app store, for example, you may see it listed in here and you'll have to unlock this section and click on allow to actually allow you to install the application. That's the first thing. The other thing is if you're using File Vault to actually encrypt your data, it's gonna just make the recovery a little bit more challenging. So I would recommend turning File Vault off if you are using it to be able to then allow you to recover some of that data a little bit easier. So you may need to unlock that and turn File Vault off. You've got a few options here. You've got a recover everything option where that is ticked, and then you've got automatically it's gonna scan your entire disk. It's gonna scan everything and try to recover as much as you can. And of course, you'll be able to select exactly what you want to recover. If you wanna be more specific, you can untick that and then specifically say, I wanna just go look for videos and audio files, for example, or you can just select everything, okay? Now in our case, we're gonna leave recover everything on. We wanna do a full, thorough, deep scan. We're gonna select on next. Now in here, you've got a couple of options. Now I've got myself my primary Macintosh hard drive, which is the hard drive that is on your Mac. If you've lost files on there, you go and recover it and scan against that and then recover from there. In my case, I had a USB stick that I accidentally formatted and lost my files on there. I'm gonna select that. Now in the bottom left-hand corner, I see this option for deep scan. Now I wanna do a full, deep, thorough scan. Of course, it's not always possible to recover everything, but you may be able to recover some stuff and even the stuff that you've actually just deleted. And now we select on scan. So that process will now begin. The interface looks really good, right? It shows you exactly what is going on. On the very far left, you've got a little progress bar there showing you the percentage scanned, what phase it's a part of. It's showing you the scanning status. So essentially what sector of that USB hard drive it's currently looking through and actually reading, how much time has elapsed, how much time it's estimating it will take. Depending on the size of the disk, it'll take longer. Let it do its thing. It'll then scan through and then you'll get a list of your results on there on exactly what you can recover. So that has now completed. Now, it can be a little bit complicated to actually identify where things are because things have been deleted, things have been overwritten. So you'll see that right here, I've got a number of different things that has been identified, right? And I can go in folder by folder and actually see what I can actually recover. So over here, I've got some raw data, some particular formats that have been actually found, some WAV files, some PNG files, so some images, for example, some PHP, right? So this is actually really, really good. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna untick this. I'm gonna recover a couple things. So let's go into PNG. So we're gonna select a number of files right here and say recover. Of course, because this is the free version, we can only recover up to 1 gig. If you do need to recover more, then you can upgrade to a different version, of course at a cost, but it's sometimes worth it if you need to recover a lot more stuff. We're gonna select upgrade later. We're gonna select that the browse destination. So where do we wanna actually save this? We're gonna say save it onto the desktop and open and then say save. Okay, so congratulations, you've successfully recovered those files. So we can select okay. All right, so that is in my desktop. So I can go ahead and open up my desktop and it's actually put into this folder. And here we go, here are the four images that we found. There it is, there's an image. If anybody knows what that is, that's a great game on the Xbox. But there you go, so it's recovered some images. So those files have been recovered, which is great. Now in my case, it hasn't found a lot of files and that's because my USB stick isn't very old. It's only been written to a certain amount of times and only some files have been deleted. That's why there's not too much in there. Of course, if you've got a hard drive that has years of data on there that have been deleted, overwritten, all that sort of stuff, you're gonna have a lot more. And you just have to sort through everything to see what you can recover. But what's great is it's found automatically 331 files in 30 folders with a possible 658 meg of data that can be recoverable. Any other data that was on there is gone because this scan will not be able to see it and you won't be able to recover that sort of data. But the interface is very, very easy to use. We can just say go back. You've also got some further settings if you want to change things you can activate online. So the software is great, very, very easy to use. I would recommend it, especially in the event that you have got no backups, you've accidentally deleted files, your hard drive has been corrupted. There is still hope for you to be able to recover the files using this software. So that was it. That's a small little demo. And as I said, it's completely free. You can download it. Of course, what we showed you here today is the Mac version. The Windows version is also available, so you can go and get that. So that's it. Thank you so much for spending the time. Please do like, comment, subscribe. Check out my other videos as well so that you don't miss out on all things tech. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.